You guys are going to absolutely love this tutorial. We're going to be using the new gradients inside of Photoshop's masks to create that floating heads like you would see in movie posters and different things. Let's get the files into Photoshop. We could choose File, Scripts, Load Files into Stack. Then we hit Browse, Find our folder, select all the images, and then just click OK. And Photoshop will load these into stacks. And now I'm just going to resize these one at a time. Let's grab the top one. Control T. And we're just going to position these around the image. Okay, once we've got all these sized, we're just going to do them one at a time. So we're going to start with this one. So what we're going to do is create a layer mask. Then we're going to grab the gradient tool. Now with gradient selected, what we're going to do is choose the foreground to transparent. Make sure foreground is set to black. And then we're going to do our radial. Okay, let's click and drag. And as we do, we can see it creates this beautiful vignette. Now we can reposition this by grabbing the center, moving it around. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right, let's go into the properties panel and we see opacity control. We can adjust the way that blends by dragging this in or out so we can get a softer blend. So what we're doing is if we're looking at this, this is 100% opacity on one end. The other end is zero. So we're just determining how we want that to blend between the two points. That looks pretty good. Let's grab the next one. Create a layer mask. With the gradient, we can just drag it out. Let's get on to opacity controls and we'll just determine how we want that one to blend. Let's go to the next one. As you see, we can actually go quite fast on this if we want. Just repeating the same steps. And you see how quickly we can blend these faces in. Now, if you wanted to go in and modify these, you could. So let's say, for example, we want to choose this one. We're going to click. Now, if you grab the gradient tool, notice that that gradient is still available. It's still editable. Now, be aware, once you close this Photoshop document and reopen it, these are going to be rasterized into the masks, meaning you can't adjust them anymore. So another thing you can do is you can actually paint on these masks as well. So if I grab a brush and make it a black brush, I select on this mask here, I can also just manually go in here and blend some of those edges if I want. If I hit the X key, I can also do the opposite and I can bring some of that back. And then once you select that gradient again, we still have the ability to edit this gradient. Then go to the properties, make sure you choose the gradient side here. And then we can go in and we can still edit this manually. So if we wanted to go in really faint, we could do that, but still paint back. Just grab the brush, take the brush, paint with white, and we can paint that face in. So it just kind of shows you get a little bit more control over how you want that to work. So let me know in the comments if you found this tutorial useful and if you learned anything new. And don't forget to also watch the second part of this series, which is how to create rainbows inside of Photoshop with the new gradients. And if you're new to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.